I welcome you all at the second day of talk journalism here at ABI. Today we have our session moderator, Mr. Kiruba Shankar, in conversation with Vignesh Vellore, Mahavir Pratap Sharma, and Anirudh Kumar. And the topic of discussion is why we invest in media. So the stage is all yours.
All right, good morning, everyone. I want, first off, hats off to you and my sincere respect for you for being punctual and for, more importantly, showing the interest to come and listen, right? So give yourself a big round of applause, really. Awesome. So I have two amazing gentlemen. I'm going to introduce them first and before I tell you who I am. So we have Mahavir Pratap Sharma, who is the chairman. Thank you. Great, thank you. Who's the chairman and the co-founder of RAIN, R-A-I-N, which stands for Rajasthan Angel Innovators Network. Another reason why you should listen to him, because he has money. All right? So if you ever have entrepreneurial ambitions, that's the guy you should keep a good eye on. So ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for Mahavir Singh Pratap. Mahavir, thank you. Our next panelist is Vignesh Vellore. He is the co-founder and he is the chief operating officer of The News Minute. The News Minute is probably the biggest online news and online portal that focuses on South India. Classic example that of a news entity that has really grown in importance and prestige. So ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for Vignesh Vellore. CEO of The News Minute. My name is Kiruba Shankar. I wear three hats. I run a social media and digital consulting company. I'm a professor of digital marketing and I'm an organic farmer over the weekends. But today, I'm like super excited for this session because I know most of us here at the audience are students. And so the first question that I have, I'm going to start off with Vignesh first and then come up to Mahavir, is, you know, this side of the students mostly are from Jaipur Engineering, complete the sentence for me. Sorry? Okay, that's great. And from Jaipur National University as well. Raise your hands, please. Right, that's fantastic. Anybody else from another organization? No, but predominantly these two. So my question is, why should students start looking at content or news media as a viable career opportunity?
So how many people are actually interested in starting something on your own in the news and media space? Okay, that's a lot of hands. So I'll talk about my personal experiences, so you know it'll be easier for you guys to understand. So we started the News Minute about 3.5 years ago. So when we started off itself, we decided that we want to work in this in the southern space. You know, the five southern states. That time there was only four, but anyway. So I think the most important focus that you guys should be looking at is what is the niche market that you're focusing on. For us, it was relatively easy because the people that we had on board were experts in the southern space itself. So when we started looking at...
I agree with the experts because I want Danya Rajinder to stand up, please, just so that you can look at her. So Danya was earlier with Times Now and earlier with another few news organizations. Is that right, Danya? Right, so Danya headed actually the bureau, the Southern Bureau for Times Now, which is awesome. And she's really the face. Come on in, take your seat next to Papa. That's awesome. So he's also the most valuable employee. He's the chief happiness officer of the News Minute. So that's awesome. So thank you, Danya. Thank you. So when Vignesh says that they have credible people backing the company up and starting, he really truly means it. Carry on.
Yeah, so full disclosure here, Danya, I'm also married to Danya. So I'm from a tech background. I worked in a software company for about 12 years. So the move into the media space was basically because I was forced into it. Okay. So since we had experts, the other founding member is also Chitra Subramaniam, who was responsible for the Bofors scam, you know, about 30 years back. So when we got a good team in place, we decided that, you know, we needed to do something in the content space because we were not happy with the amount of content which was available in the southern market. So initially we started off as an aggregator. We wanted to do things very differently. So we wanted to focus on being a very lean model. So we started off with about 5 people and we were just purely aggregating content from the southern states. So we used to pick news articles from a Times of India, NDTV or whatever publication which was focusing on the with southern stories. And then we did this for about 5 to 6 months, and then we realized that we were not getting enough content. So it was not easily available. So there was a lot of content in the vernacular space, but there was not enough content which was translating from the vernacular space into the English space at all. So when we saw that void, we said, you know, why not do this? So we hired a couple of reporters and then started focusing on our own stories, our own reporting. So that got consumed really well. So about 6-8 months into running the News Minute, we realized that this is the focus which we should, you know, start building upon. So 8 months down the line, we said, okay, we'll go back to the drawing board, change our strategies. We stopped being an aggregator. We do still aggregate some kind of news stories right now, but the focus has always been on creating our own content. So we're looking at, undiscovered stories or, you know, underreported stories. So Vice has this model where they go in and pick out news content which is underreported.
I'll come to the operations bit of it. Mm-hmm. But before the session, I very politely, very nicely walked up to Vignesh and said, Vignesh, you're such a handsome guy. You know, you're so awesome. Can you tell me how much is your company worth? You know, so I can throw a number, then your eyes will pop up and you will listen better. And you know what happened? He was even more nicer to me and said that, Kiruba, you are even more handsome. I will not tell you the number. But he did say, no, let him be seated. Don't worry about it. Let him be there. So the beautiful thing is that he never said, but he did say other news companies and gave a rough valuation. It's about 100 crores, about 60 crores, about 50 crores, which is awesome, right? How many of you like to have that money? Right, now you know. It's a classic example of how a person like Danya quits a high-profile job like Times Now. Vignesh, who worked in one single company, a technology company in Chennai for 12 long years, and quits us to start, and look at them. Such successful people out there. Another successful person is Mahavir. How many of you know Mahavir already? So Mahavir is brilliant. So he's one of my favorite panelists because he really speaks his mind out, doesn't mince words. So Mahavir, you have multiple hats. You run a carpet export company. He's on the global board of Thai Global. That Indus Entrepreneurs is arguably the world's best entrepreneurial network out there. So he's on the global board. He's also the co-founder and chairman of RAIN, Rajasthan Angel Innovators Network. So tell us about first what got you into being an investor, and you invested in 2 media companies. Why?
When I was traveling for Thai and attending various angel and VC conferences, I realized that Rajasthan or Jaipur, in fact, was lacking in local opportunities of investment. And investment does not mean investing money, because when you come to us for investment, 1 out of 50 or 100 gets invested. But while we are negotiating, while we're asking questions, while we are debating whether you are up and ready for investment, you are learning a lot. We ask the right questions, we put the right doubts in your mind, we challenge you, we tell you to do things right or differently. And so that's what I think was lacking in Jaipur. And I think no one can give gyan bina paise, without the back. You would not listen to any of us if I did not back it up with funding, if you had the right answers. So we really wanted to put our monies as Thai members and bring out an angel fund in Rajasthan. And that's the reason why we launched RAIN. Now we're investing all across India. So because, there is no reason why when we have the infrastructure, we would not invest in other parts of India. Why I invested in the online space? I think or the media space. I think media, and especially online media, is the future of the world. world. Print will exist, television will exist, but online will have a different feel to it, a different reach to it, for multiple reasons that all of you know. You know, I can read my news whenever I want to. I can download and read it at 3 a.m. It can be updated. I can read news. I can read blogs. Everything is now mobile. Everything is now moving. I don't have to wait for the news hour at 9 p.m. or whatever channel, you know, if I don't have to. So I think this is a future. And I felt that this future, though not easily monetizable, though not revenue generating at this point, though having thousands of online news portals and news aggregators or news channels, needed some support. And so we looked at the right two models. We looked at the right team, and that was primarily the reason why we invested in two domains, and we invested in those things. And the team and the ideas that they brought forward at a very early stage, idea stage, without any validation, we invested.
I thought you will take this cue as a way to pitch your own startups that you invested in. No?
No. I think Tech Portal and Collage are two very good investments that we've made. Collage is something where you can put up your articles and mainline media will and can pick this thing. You can go to Collage.
If somebody is interested in content generation, writing, that can be a place to look at.
And reading to understand and learn of opinions. So news are different kinds of news. I mean, news is current news, which is happening right now. And news is opinions and you know, debates and blogs, and so Collage is one such place where you can share your thoughts and ideas, and it can be picked up by mainline media across the world, not just India. So they're tying up with London and New York magazines and newspapers also. Tech News is Tech Portal is just Tech News, TechCrunch of India kind of a news, and they're current and online. So there are two different verticals, two different ideas, but I thought unique in their own way, needed support because revenue happens much later after lots of traction, lots of you know, people visiting. So I think they needed support, and I'm not very excited about return on investments. Rather than them succeeding and becoming mediums for all of us as citizens or writers to express ourselves.
So Vignesh, walk us through the embryo of the business. So when you and Dhanya decided that, hey, you know what, it's maybe we should try starting our own company. From that time, how did you build it up to the level that you guys are in?
Yeah, so since the time we actually started the NewsMint, to be very honest, the honest answer to this would be we're still learning. So every day it's been a learning process for us, and then we've been able to understand there are different models which we can capitalize on. So if you want to talk about only the monetization aspect of it, see right now the reach that the digital medium is working on, the television is about 5 or 6 times ahead of what the digital space is right now. But in another matter of 3 or 4 years, we're not talking about 10, 15, but another 3 to 4 years, that reach will even out. So the numbers that we're looking at right now in terms of digital to television will become comparable. When that happens, advertisers will be forced to move into the digital space and, you know, to look at different channels of monetization. Now, you can't just rely on, you know, starting a portal and saying that, you know, hey, I'll produce a good amount of content, people will start reading, I'll put like 3 or 4 ads, and then I'll be able to self-sustain. That is not going to be the case. So you'll have to start looking at different channels of monetization. See, we at the NewsMint are looking at events as a medium. We have become a content creating engine where we create content for different brands. You know, we're looking at native advertising. We are also sticking to the age old display ads because the numbers are good. So you've got Facebook and Google also trying to help a lot of publishers right now. So they have increased their CPMs, you know, which helps, you know, publishers like us. But the key to sustaining a business, at least what we at the NewsMint follow, is we've tried to stay lean. You know, even when we got our first level of funding, we didn't go ballistic. And
by the way, the person who funded the NewsMint is Raghav Bell, the guy who started, who's the man behind CNN, IBN, CNBC. Is that right?
Yes. Yeah. Network 18. Yeah.
Network 18.
Yeah. So basically, what we did was from the beginning when we started about 5 to 6 people. We kept it as lean as possible. We looked at organic modes of growing. You know, we didn't want to go and use social media extensively where we actually promote our content and pay a lot of money to, you know, these social media platforms to get discoverability. We took the organic route. So it is a longer route, but it's a more sustainable route at the end of the day. So right now we've been scaling up very, conservatively. And right now we operate with a team size of about 22 people. In terms of traffic, we are pretty much equal to a lot of other sites which are there, at least the independent sites. Yeah. We're not talking about...
Give a number. I'm sure you can share
that. Yeah, so basically we're doing about 5 million in terms of uniques. We do about 20 million page views right now. So the last year we were doing about a million uniques. So we've grown 4 times. So
20 million page views a month?
Yes, 20 million page views a month.
Wow.
Yeah. So the key is to keep it as lean as possible. You know, you can get in some kind of funding. A lot of VCs are right now interested in funding, you know, investment into the media houses. But grow, you know, slowly. You know, we've added vertical by vertical, you know, over a very long period of time. You know, we've not dabbled into the entertainment space or something, but this is something that we've just done recently. So if you can keep the team lean, then that means you're able to cut your costs down. So eventually, when the ad industry grows, you should be able to sustain yourself.
Hmm. They say that when you're an entrepreneur, you must actually approach a few VCs because they will shake you up. They will ask you the hard questions for you to know. And that's exactly what Mahavir has a PhD in. So I'm sure you would have met a lot of startups. And before you put your hard-earned money into the two startups, what were some of the most insightful questions that you grilled them?
So, keeping your team lean is a very, very critical thing. And we do ask them the money that you're going to put in, is where is the money going in? Is it in the team? Is it in the technology? Is it in marketing and sales? And as soon as we get that pie chart, if we see anything that's lopsided and that's marketing and, you know, sales, there's a red flag. If you have to spend too much money on getting people to your website, that means you are not doing something right. So the question, biggest question, if he was investing in team and R&D, I'd be happy. If he was investing in marketing and sales and Facebook and Google, et cetera, it's a red flag. So we do ask where the money is going. Content, or the core of your business, and in his case, if he has original content, traffic will come to him. People, you know, the growth, whether organic, is all driven by quality content. So his lean team, so long as they're creating quality content, so that is what we look at. Is the founder, co-founder, the team focused on what is the right direction to go? To advertise and get people, or to create a good product and get people? That's the most important thing, and whether they have the ability to do that. So if you are spending marketing and your cost of customer acquisition is very high, angel or VCs will not invest in you. It's definitely a definite no-no. The ability to create content, the fact that he's a technology and she's a media background, makes a great team. So your team, the reasons why we've invested, and I've told you that, is because of the team. The team had the ability to deliver what they were promising us to deliver. And then gone are the days when you would get great amounts of funding. I don't know if you got your funding in one chunk or you got it in staggered. So now funding for non-tangible, and media is one of the non-tangible investments for us, has to be on stages, on page views, on achieving a target, achieving a goal, and then you get the second or the third tranche. It's a process. We have now cut down on investments that are not yet validated by the market, not yet revenue generating, to based upon one or two or three different levels that you have to achieve. So you can't fool an investor. Gone are those 3-4 years ago when you could get funding because your idea was unique and great. It's a very tough deal now. You have to back up your promises, your content, your product to a very large group of people who've become wiser and sensible and have kind of curtailed the money fund flow right now.
Got it. So we have Sachin Kalbag, fantastic person. He's the editor of the Hindu newspaper, Western Region, Sachin. So, Sachin, I want to take your, can we have the microphone passed on to him, please? Sachin, I want to take your opinion on, you know, the Hindu is a century-year-old brand out there. What is your opinion of new media startups, the Scroll, the News Minutes, Scoop Oops? How do you look at it from a traditional media point of view?
I don't think they're competitors in the real sense, in the sense that, you know, we look, the print media has changed the way news has been presented in the newspaper ever since the advent of 24-hour television. So news media itself, I mean, the print news media itself has evolved over a period of time. What we do is in the online space, we compete with all of them. So there, it's an equal ground for all of us to compete in. Whether it is news and news or opinion or blogs or live videos or Facebook Lives or Periscope or whatever that you may call it, the ability to reach to an event and break news first is still the most important part when it comes to online medium. But the ability of a print newspaper to enhance its news role and become an opinion maker, that is somewhere, you know, I think where the future of competition will lie, because given the amount of analysis, given the amount of debates that are taking place on television, websites like Scroll or News Minute or The Wire or Quint or HuffPost, etc., traditional media will find them to be a really big competition. Mm. I don't think that print media, just because of its size at present, can wish them away,
right,
because we are already competing with them.
Right.
So, like Mahavir said, if there's a genuine amalgamation of technology and content, I think it's an unbeatable proposition. Mm. I think over the period of the next 3 to 4 years, traditional media will also have to invest in new technology, get more readers in than advertising. For example, The Hindu did not spend a rupee on advertising when The Hindu Mumbai edition was launched. Okay. I was a bit angry about it, because, you know, we wanted to get some visibility.
Sure.
But even if I'm saying so, right now the Bombay edition goes to around 8 different cities in the space of 1.5 years. So the customer acquisition or the reader acquisition has happened through the organic route, like Vignesh pointed out. We did not advertise, we did not do any kind of marketing. We still are the most expensive newspaper in the city of Mumbai. When we sell it in Ahmedabad, it's 13 rupees per day. On Sundays, it is 15 rupees.
Wow.
So despite that price barrier, there are people who are willing to take good content and buy good content. I think subscription models plus technology plus the right investment in people will determine the future of all these media.
Got it. Thank you. That's phenomenal. Thank you so much, Sachin. To the my friend who's handling the camera, can you just point out? Yeah. Sir, when somebody is speaking in the audience, I want you to turn it around and focus on them. Yeah, thank you so much. Thank you. So that's a big statement coming from Sachin. You know, traditional media, they look at sites as competition, which is great. But I want to ask you the other way around. You know, Times of India is a massive brand. The Hindu is century old. You can't beat it in credibility. You know, what amazing pedigree. How are you guys taking on the big boys? Are you not scared? So what is your, I want to hear about your sentiments.
See, when it comes to the web, I think everybody, like, you know, Sachin pointed out, it's an even playing ground. So the reason why we don't look at Times of India or any of the bigger publications, the legacy media, as competition for us right now is because we're doing our own thing right now. So, like, and there's a sea of content available on these sites. How do you actually discover this? So if you come to the News Minute, the reader has invariably understood that, you know, you're coming to the News Minute because you're focusing only on the 5 southern states. We're not going to put out like some 250 copies or 300 copies a day, because obviously we don't have the bandwidth to do it. So what do we do instead is, you know, our ability to even break news may not be as high as what, you know, the other media houses can. So what do? We go a step further. What is the other kind of content we can work on the current news cycle? So if there is a crime which has happened in Chennai, we just don't report the crime. We also look at a sea of content which we can create around that, and which is what is getting us the recognition, because you're playing on something which is already there in the news cycle at this point in time. So there's a lot of other things that we do as well. We look at the social media angle. We use social media extensively, and we are able to gather a lot of followers around, you know, from there. So when you come to the News Minute, people have already understood that, hey, there is a certain kind of angle that they're taking. There is a certain kind of an analysis that we've done on a regular news cycle. So we use that to our advantage and try to push out as much content as we can at that point in time, which is what the other media houses don't do. You know, so they report the news, they've broken the news, and probably they stop there. So we go to the next level. What can we do around that? And that's actually worked very well to our advantage. The other thing is we focus a lot on the hyper-local content, as we call it. You know, it's something which is happening in a suburb, which could be very highly relevant to a person sitting in a Delhi or a Bombay. So we call it the hyper-local content for a pan-India reach. So we did an article on the 500-meter rule in Kerala, mm-hmm. I mean in the whole of the country, so where there was a bar owner in
this
Kerala.
This is the alcohol ban in highways.
Yeah, that's what the alcohol ban in the highways. So this small town in Kerala, there was a bar owner who actually created a maze which amounted to 500 meters, and then he was selling alcohol. Now that is content we feel is very good for the digital space. You know, it may not be a good article which you would read on the print because you'll see the photo and then probably exit, but from a digital perspective, it works a lot. The content is short, there's a picture, and you're just done with it. So that got us a lot of readership. Mm. You know, a traditional media house may not want to look at that as an article which they would want to write about. So these are some small stories that we pick around, which we feel that are being ignored, which works very well to our advantage.
Got it. So I've got a note here that says, if you don't finish on time, we will kick you off the stage. So thank you. That was, no, I was just kidding. So we have, our time is limited, but I want to quickly ask a poll. So raise your hands if it's right. How many of you speak with each other in Hindi? Raise your hands. If you're communicating with your friends, as a normal one, that's great. That's almost everybody. Put your hands down, please. How many of you have a Hindi paper or Rajasthani paper, regional language paper, coming to your house? Raise your hands. Right? Whoa, that's like 90% coming to you. So here's my question to you. You saw the numbers right out there. Vernacular language is the fastest growing medium. Yesterday, the head of YouTube said that that's the biggest area that they're focusing on. If that is the case, why did you, Mahavir, invest in English language? Both the companies that you invested is English language, and you, Vignesh, started an English language portal. Explain.
I guess search engines don't let you search in Hindi. You end up typing, and to get traffic to a site, English has to be the core medium, and it's easy. English connects South and North, UK and Europe and US and China. So English is the language of the world, and it's easier to get traction, easier to get numbers offhand. But the growth does lie in different languages in different countries, like Tech Portal is going to Indonesia and China. So there is this thing, but I think English, to establish yourselves in a credible this thing on a media platform, you have to have English as a language, because that will cross barriers. That will is easy to get on terms of search. It's easy to grow in at initial stages. So I think that's the reason why we started off in English, and nothing against Hindi or any other language. We're not against anything.
Got it. Vignesh?
Yeah, from our perspective, yeah, the reason why we went into English was because our bandwidth only allowed us to do that much. So everybody was from the English background. They were already working in television or papers which were publishing in English. We definitely believe that the growth pattern lies in getting into the vernacular space. But the constraints that we as a small website have, you know, we're not moving from English to one language, which is Hindi. We've got four languages that we should be focused on. So if we have to go into four languages, then we're looking at an additional team size, which is equivalent to the number we're already functioning in. We have actually experimented with Malayalam and Tamil, which actually worked well, but we were not able to spend enough amount of time to make sure that, you know, we were able to grow that vertical in itself. So we will definitely go into the vernacular languages, probably not at this point in time, but we definitely will. So.
Got it. So you got another few minutes. Any questions specifically? Yes, ma'am. Can we have the microphones passed on? You can, yeah, perfect.
Good morning. Good morning, sir. My name is Shruti Sharma and I'm from JCRC University. My question is to Vinesh, sir. What is the most challenging and exciting project you have done in past 2 years?
Easy answer. Yeah,
maybe I should just give it to Danya because she handles editorial. She'd probably be the best person to answer that.
Can you pass the mic to Danya there, please?
Yeah.
I think there are a lot of challenges, like for example, like what Sachin said, the question which I keep asking to myself is, why should someone who reads the Deccan Chronicle, the Deccan Herald, the Hindu come to us to read? So one story which we identified as something which we should be ahead of even legacy media is the former Tamil Nadu Chief Minister Jayalalitha's hospitalization and her death. So we decided to put all our resources onto that one story and make sure that we were ahead of everyone else when it came to breaking news, when it came to all the stories related to it. And I think we did a considerably good job because we got a lot of credible and very loyal readership after that entire event. So we now focus on a specific event. If there's an event happening in a city or in a village, like for example, the hydrocarbon project in a village called Kadiramangalam in Tamil Nadu, that's getting a lot of opposition. So we pick that topic and then we work around it. So people know that, okay, they're consistently reporting on that. We can't do everything, right, for 20 people. We can only pick up a few issues. So I think the hospitalization, death, and the political chaos which followed in Tamil Nadu, that was one huge project that we took on as far as reporting is concerned. And I think we did okay. We did well.
Yeah, so we did about 75 stories just from Jayalalitha's hospitalization till her unfortunate death.
Sounds good. Another question? Yes, ma'am? Go.
Good morning, sir. I'm Aditi Rathi from JCRC University. My question is for Mahavir, sir. Sir, investing in a media company, what are the benefits of doing that? Other than getting a good return in terms of money, other than that?
So actually there is no, I don't expect huge return. I mean, I would expect more returns from other investments than I would from a media company, pro rata basis, for the same amount of money that I invest in a media company to other technology, pure technology based, SaaS based, I would have a much higher rate of return than on media. My reasons for investment on media was purely because I feel that the younger generation, the future as a society in India, it lies in debate, in discussions, in openly discussing, and online, or this, all this medium has brought us all together where we can value each other's opinions, learn from each other's opinions. We might not agree. So I really wanted to support the young and budding entrepreneurs and the thoughts that they brought and the idea that they brought, because I think the future lies in all of you. The future lies in debate and discussion of any healthy country or the economy to grow. And I think this online medium, online portals have brought a great platform. So it's not money for sure.
Thank you, sir.
All right, one last question. By the way, guys, the girls are beating you hands down. What's wrong with guys here? All right, the lady here, and then we'll wrap it up.
Sir, myself Rishi Sharma, again from JCRC University. So I would have a common question, and I would like to ask, like, is there something specific we need to do to retain readership, like to retain the readers and to grow our readers, like who are reading our news?
See, I think the primary thing over here is to make sure that you create a niche for yourself. And once the reader identifies and says that, okay, fine, this is the niche that you're playing on, this is why I'm going to a site. See, we ask our reporters a very specific question. Why are we doing this story? We do this story because it's related to the South, but we're also having an approach which, you know, reaches to the entire country. If you're able to define your niche very early on, when you start whatever you want to start, I think then it's a lot more easier to actually get more people to start reading it. Social media plays a big facilitator in moving your content. Okay, so you have to start using that effectively as much as possible. Don't think that, you know, you just put out an article and you decided, okay, fine, my niche is to write on the entertainment industry or whatever, Bollywood or cricket or whatever it is, and I've got very good content. Don't assume that people are going to come there and start reading it. It's not going to be the case. Okay, first thing is credibility. How credible is your news? beyond before that is what is your area that you're focusing on. If two things you can get right, and then you can leverage on, you know, social media angles or influencers in Twitter and Facebook and all that, I think you should be able to, you know, get your readership.
I'll just add on to that and take it a step further. And a question for the audience: how many of you picked the first newspaper that was coming to your house when you were a child and your parents were reading it? How many of you read that paper, whether it's Patrika Bhaskar, Times of India? How many of you do that? We're all habitual to certain media. So if they could get people to come on the Jayalalitha story, 75 stories that they did, if they start to come to that portal, that will be the first portal that they will go to. So you have to addict people by content, whatever he said, quality, transparency, whatever, the content has to be good. Once you get people and you have to focus, like Times of India, why would you read Times of India, or why would you go on the Times of India news portal? Because the headlines, their opinions, whatever. But when you go to the tech news, I can assure you the tech portal has news 48 hours before Times of India has on tech, because they're focused on tech. So if you wanted tech news, you will not go to Times of India tech niche, because it's like way down on the page, because that's not a priority. They don't have a focus team. So they are focusing on South. Pick a topic, pick a subject, pick an area, pick anything that you want, that you have strengths in. Get people to come to that, in that genre, in that area, and then slowly, gradually go to diversify to other languages. Make people come to you as a habit, as a top three, like Google, you know, searches or whatever. You have to really get people to addict it to yourselves.
Yeah, that's a brilliant solution. So one is, of course, passion. The ability to focus is something that's very strong. Like Vignesh and Dhanya focused on South, and they were very, very clear about it. And here in this case, identifying team, if it is tech portal, only get people who are passionate in that area. And that's the reason for their success. Ladies and gentlemen, give them a big round of applause. A phenomenal plan. Thank you so much, guys. Thank you.